It's like a brownie. It's like a chocolate bar, like Snickers. And it's a date.
These chocolate-covered, peanut butter-filled dates are the most decadent, simple, no-bake dessert. Soft, gooey, caramelly, chocolatey, easy to make deliciousness. The first time I ate a date like this was at a dinner party, and a friend had brought these as a dessert. And I was looking at these strange, shrivelly things, thinking this is not a dessert. Oh boy, was I wrong. Now I am singing about dates from the rooftop. They are called Nature's Caramel, and it is for a reason. They're so strange looking on the outside, this dried fruit. It has a pit, but on the inside is just soft, gooey, caramelly, absolute wonderfulness. We always have two kinds of dates in our fridge, these big and juicy Medjool dates and these smaller Deglet Nour dates. And you can see the difference here. So this is a Medjool date. It's darker in color. It has a pit inside, so you'll have to remove that before you eat it. And this is a Deglet Nour, and it's lighter in color, it doesn't have a pit, and it's not quite as sweet. So we keep these for grinding down in our baking as a sweetener, and we keep these to enjoy in all their glory. So this is what you're looking for this recipe. So we're gonna start by just slicing into your date and take out that pit. Sometimes there's a harder piece of stem there as well, so you can take that out. And now we're gonna fill that with some peanut butter, and then you can sprinkle in some almonds or peanuts, or just leave it with the peanut butter, and that's gonna be super tasty. And then try to close your date back up, and then we're gonna pop these in the freezer for about 15 minutes while we melt some chocolate. Now for the chocolate, we're going to make this really easy and melt the chocolate in the microwave. So I have 1 cup of chocolate with 2 teaspoons of coconut oil, and using a neutral oil will help to thin out the chocolate. So I find that I use less chocolate and it makes it a lot easier to coat the dates. So you can melt your chocolate on the stovetop over really low heat or using a double boiler method. But if you're using the microwave, we're going to heat it for 30 seconds. Take it out, give the chocolate a stir, and then heat in increments of about 10 seconds after that, and I'll show you what it looks like when your chocolate is just melted. By stirring your chocolate in between heating it up, you can use the heat from the chocolate to melt the remaining chocolate chips. And this will make sure that you don't overheat your chocolate and end up burning it. And now for the dipping. Take your frozen dates, dip them in the chocolate one at a time. You're gonna cover it with the chocolate, take a fork, and let that excess drip off. Transfer it to a piece of parchment paper and sprinkle your dates with your favorite toppings. We love colorful sprinkles, coconut, some more crushed almonds, or an extra drizzle of chocolate. And once all your dates are coated, you're going to transfer these to the fridge for at least 30 minutes to an hour. But if you can leave them overnight, they're gonna hold up that much better.
When your dates are done, you need to treat yourself to a moment of bliss because these are so good.
It totally covers my craving for something like a Cadbury cream egg, and those cost us about $1 to $1.50 each. And 12 of these are less than 50 cents each. So you need to hit that link below for this recipe and subscribe for a new video every Sunday at 5. And let me know in the comments if you think that this is better than a candy bar.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe, like, comment, and share. We love to hear from you. We'll see you for the next one.